Welcome back to episode 2 of Point of View, the medical news. Today, 24th April 2021, and I am here with the top 7 medical updates of last week. Let's go into the video now. More than half of women of reproductive age suffer from anemia in Maharashtra, a study says. The researchers studied anemia in women aged 15 and 49 across 36 districts of Maharashtra. A later study has revealed that over 50% women of prime reproductive age in Maharashtra are suffering from anemia, and the highest prevalence of such women is in Vidarbha region of the state. Anemia is caused due to the deficiency of iron, vitamin A, and B12 in the body. When a person suffers from anemia, the number of red blood cells decline and thus reduces blood's oxygen carrying capacity. The latest study is conducted by Kaustav Ghosh from Pune's Gokhale Institute of Politics and Economics and Mithun Mogh from National Institute of Technology, Agartala, according to a report in Indian Express. The researchers' duo studied anemia in women aged 15 and 49 across 36 districts of Maharashtra. Health experts consider anemia as a public health menace that leads to reduced cognitive development, reduced productivity, and impaired sexual and reproductive development. The report revealed that 54.2% of women are anemic in Maharashtra, and this indicates a severe public health problem. The report further said that number of anemics had increased by 6.2% between 2014-2015 and 2019-2020. Outdoor mask wearing no longer required in Israel after drop in infection rate. Amid a drop in COVID-19 infection rates in Israel, the country's health ministry has cancelled the mandatory wearing of masks in the open air starting Sunday. Following the drop in infection rates, the Israel Health Ministry advised the public not to wear coverings at large outdoor gatherings and stressed that mask wearing is still obligatory indoors. According to the Russian news agency, Israel started vaccinating its population against the COVID-19 on December 20 last year, and the country has seen one of the most rapid vaccine rollouts of anywhere in the world. Bharat Biotech ups capacity to produce 700 million Covaxin doses annually to meet surging demand. Hyderabad-based Bharat Biotech said on Tuesday it has expanded its manufacturing capacity across multiple facilities in the city and Bangalore to produce 700 million doses of Covaxin annually. The announcement comes at a time when India reported 2,59,170 fresh coronavirus infections and 1,761 fatalities. The government on Monday approved a payment of ₹4,500 crore as advance to vaccine makers, including Bharat Biotech and Serum Institute of India. Vaccines for all above 18 years of age from May 1, states can buy directly. Amid a virulent second wave of COVID-19 infections, the government has allowed vaccination of all persons above the age of 18 from May 1. The decision announced on Monday evening followed a meeting of Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday with pharma companies, doctors, cabinet ministers in charge of health, drugs and officials spanning multiple nodal ministries. Spanking may change children's brain, a study says. The study published in Child Development used functional MRIs to map brain changes in 147 twins who had never experienced physical or sexual abuse. Researchers tracked which part of the children's brain activated in response to neutral or fearful facial expressions. When shown pictures of someone looking fearful, kids who reported having been spanked had a larger response in certain parts of the brain than kids who hadn't been. Those areas drive the response to environmental cues, recognizing threats and reacting to them. If a child's brain overreacts, behavioral changes can result. Breast cancer, now most common form of cancer. World Health Organization taking action. Breast cancer has now overtaken lung cancer as the world's most commonly diagnosed cancer, according to statistics released by the International Agency for Research on Cancer, IARC, in December 2020. So on World Cancer Day, World Health Organization will host the first of a series of consultations in order to establish a new global breast cancer initiative, which will launch later in 2021. This collaborative effort between World Health Organization, IARC, the International Atomic Energy Agency, and other multi-sectoral partners will reduce death from breast cancer by promoting breast health, improving timely cancer detection, and ensuring access to quality care. While changes in lifestyle, such as unhealthy diet, insufficient physical activity, use of tobacco, and harmful use of alcohol have all contributed to the increasing cancer burden, a significant proportion can also be attributed to increasing longevity as the risk of developing cancer increases with age. This reinforces the need to invest in both cancer prevention and cancer control, focusing on actionable cancers like breast, cervical, and childhood cancers. New drug approval. Nextstell is drospirenone and estetrol tablets, which is produced by Mayne Pharma US, and the date of approval is April 15, 2021.
It is used as contraceptives.
Nextstell is, that is, drospirenone and estetrol, is a progestin and estrogen combination indicated for use by females of reproductive potential to prevent pregnancy. FDA approves Nextstell is oral contraceptive for birth control on April 15th, 2021.
Hope you guys like this video. So please do subscribe to Dr. Medicine and share this video with your friends. Thank you all. See you in next video.